Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace, Aleya, and today it's another Tip Trick Tuesday. In today's Tip Trick Tuesday, I will be showing you a simple tip on how to animate characters inside of Adobe After Effects. I've already been making some tutorials on this kind of technique, but I find it so much fun, and it's actually a part of a bigger tutorial that I'm still working on, and it's kind of Halloween related. That's why I thought of redoing this tutorial, because I find it so much fun, you can do so many things with it. And yeah, basically in this tutorial, we're going to be animating a flying bat. And when you want to try and animate something, try to look up how the movement actually works. Try to actually imitate that movement. Like if you would be flying, you would go up if you push down, you go low so the body actually moves. You find that the wings kind of roll off. So yeah, you would be looking funny if you would do this in an office, but actual animation companies also do that before they go for a walk cycle. They would actually try and do that walk cycle. So it's really important that you look up how the actual movement goes and try to imitate it yourself. So without further ado, let's jump into Adobe After Effects and see how we're going to animate this. All right, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and as you can see, I have this image here of a bat, and it's a frontal image, and we just want to animate it flying. So if you have an image of a bird or any of these kinds, it's actually super easy to animate them if you're going to use them in like long distance shots. So of course you don't want any kind of close-ups of this bat. This bat doesn't look realistic enough for that, but oftentimes you see in a shot like birds flying in the sky, bats flying at night, and you kind of can fake all these animations simply in After Effects with a simple tool without being an actual animator. So first of all, once you want to animate something, really think of how that animation is going to look, like I said in the intro, and we are going to drag this into a new composition here at first. So what I'll do is click on my layer, and then right over here you see this option for the puppet tool, the puppet pin tool. If you click on that, we can actually click on our image right here to make kind of joints. So we want a joint over here, maybe over here and here, and actually also here. And then we want maybe a few joints over here on the bed itself, just to make sure it's not really animating. Over here, and then another one here, here, and then again over here at the end. Okay, so now we have made some joints for our bat, and instantly if we're going to press U on the keyboard, you're going to see that we have a bunch of keyframes right here for all these joints. So let's move 10 frames forward. So hold shift and press the page down key. Now we can animate it. So, well, before we start animating, actually we're going to set this like it's a slap down, like the bat is kind of trying to go upwards. So how we'll do that is actually click on this one and this one first, and we're going to drag this down and then also bring this one down. Okay, there we go. And really think of these dots like real actual joints. So we can actually move these. There we go. Looks pretty good in my opinion. Maybe a little bit closer to the body. So we can do something like that. And the body, actually, we want to move it up. So we're going to click on one of these joints, hold shift, and select the other ones. And then move this up. And there we go. Maybe also play a little bit with these joints so everything looks kind of right. Okay, there we go. So now we have a nice flap upwards. And now we're going to move forward. So hold shift and press page down. And in this case, we want to make this go. Again, we're going to select all of these, holding shift. And now we want to bring this down and this up. Kind of try to make it somewhat right. As you can see, it's not perfect, but gets the job done pretty well, in my opinion. Okay, we can drag this out a little bit more, and there we go. So now we have this animation. And already it looks kind of good. So what we're going to do is now select all of our first keyframes and copy these, and then go to the second keyframes. Again, go 10 frames forward and then paste these keyframes. So now we have a kind of loop. Then go one frame backwards with the page up key.
And then we're going to press N on the keyboard, and let's preview this. Okay, so basically that's already very nice. And what you can do is go over here again and maybe animate it a little bit better to go a little bit higher maybe, like you want. And another thing I want to do is select all of these keyframes and hold Alt and drag them in. And that's going to speed up the process right over here. And then go one frame forward, always go one frame from the end and press N, because that way you don't have any double keyframes. For example, if I would make this one frame longer, this would have the exact same value as this one. But if we make it one frame shorter, it's going to stop at one frame before the exact value of the beginning. And that's going to make that a seamless, perfect loop. And there we have it. So that looks pretty nice. And if we're going to enable motion blur here for this layer, actually the layer and then motion blur for the composition, we're going to see that now we have some motion blur in the wings, and look how cool that already looks. So, okay, so this is getting there in my opinion. Maybe we want to make it go down a little bit more as the body itself. So we can go again here and bring it a little bit more down so we have a little bit more of a harsh animation. And maybe over here we want to make it go up a little bit better. And just make sure that you select all these keyframes and go at the end here and paste them over here. Okay, so let's see. Yes, okay, there we have it. Super nice. We have our animations. If we're going to go to effects, curves, and like bring this down a little bit, make it dark. Let's bring in a sky just quickly. And if we're going to click on the bat, we can go for layer, pre-compose, and move all the attributes in here. And if we go into that layer, you'll see here we have this entire range of our animation. We want to right-click on that and trim the comp to work area. And now if we go back to our first composition, and we can go and right-click, and go for time and enable time remapping. And now hold Alt and click on the stopwatch for the time remapping and go into this arrow here and simply go to property and loop out, like right here, loop out. And if you select that, it's going to make a loop as long as your timeline lasts. And there we have a loop of our bat, and we can now simply just make it smaller, put it over here and then kind of keyframe the position, move off screen, and maybe also go and animate the scale. And duplicate this one. Move it over. And maybe also go for an offset here. And now we have like a few of these. And it's completely up to you what you're going to do with them. So maybe bring this down like this. And of course, if you have a particle generator like Particular, you can just drop this in as a texture and use it that way. But that's going to be for a different tutorial. But see how cool that already looks just using it that way.
All right, so that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for any digital creative. And if you buy something from our website, it really helps to support this channel, so that would be awesome. And apart from that, I hope to see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.